Hi, my name is Owe Forsberg. I'm the Vice President here at IDCON. Today I'm going to talk about how to calculate your work order backlog and manage your backlog. So what's the principle of backlog management? Well, it's about managing your long-term resources and making sure that work is completed in a timely manner. So let's take an example. You have 10 technicians in an area. They work a 40-hour week. That equals 400 hours, and that is one crew week. You should think about the backlog as the volume of a tank. You know, if you put in a certain amount of gallons, take out the same amount of gallons, you're going to have an equal level in the tank. And that's what we're trying to accomplish here. So if you have 1,200 hours to be planned and in planning, and another 1,200 hours work to ready to be scheduled or planning completed, that adds up to 2,400 hours. So if you divide that by 400, you get 6 crew weeks of total backlog. So best practice is to have around 4 to 6 weeks of work, depending on the industry, mostly process industry. Some of the issues that we run into is that the screening approval of work request requires you to make a guesstimate of time before the planning of the work order. And that usually is a pretty rough estimate, but it requires you have some idea what's going on in your backlog. So if you don't estimate the time, you're not going to have a good idea what your real backlog size is. So what do you do if the backlog is too big? You have three options. You can work overtime, you can bring in contractors, or if it's a long-term issue, you can hire more people. You can get more information at idcon.com, and we will be back with some more information about planning and scheduling next week. Thank you.